The owner of this polypropylene hockey murder mask recently took an axe blade to the face. Instead of replacing this mask, to which the owner has grown very emotionally attached, it can be easily repaired using products from Polyvance. Use Polyvance's 1000 Super Prep or 1001 Eco Prep to remove dirt, grime, and the blood of 1000 victims from the repair area. Use aluminum tape to reinforce the repair area. Failure to do so could mean melting through the plastic, which could be very, very, very bad. Use 80 grit sandpaper to scuff the area that is to be repaired. Using a nitrogen plastic welder, weld a pass of polypropylene ribbon along the crack where the axe met the owner's forehead. Be sure to apply proper temperature to avoid overheating and distorting the plastic. The fiery underworld might not have been able to melt this mask, but I wouldn't risk it if I were you. To provide additional structural strength for contact with future axe blades, we'll now repair the front side of the mask. Grind a V-groove along the crack using a rotary tool, then weld another pass of polypropylene. Smooth the weld using an airless plastic welder, then trim off any additional plastic using a razor knife, machete, chainsaw, or meat cleaver. Using 80 grit sandpaper on a DA sander, finish sand the weld. Due to the nature of this repair, it would be impossible to make it look brand new, so you'll just have to pray that your customer thinks it looks cool and doesn't insist on using your blood as a waterborne primer. Many murder mask repair technicians may have elected to replace this murder mask rather than repair it, but as you can see, damage such as this is easily repairable using tools and supplies from Polyvance.